Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today in this video I am going to show you how you can easily run PHP file on our browser. So I am going to show you how to install XAMPP, how to set up our XAMPP, how to create PHP files, how to run that using our XAMPP server on our browser. So you can also use WAM server as well. I have already made a detailed video about WAM server. So if you want to run your PHP file using WAM server, so that also you can do. So in this video, I am going to show you about XAMPP server. So how to use XAMPP server for our PHP projects. So do watch the video till the end. If you face any issues in middle, you can always comment in your comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. And don't forget to subscribe our channel. That really motivate me to make more such videos. Now to install XAMPP, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and to just simply search over here XAMPP download and hit enter, and you can see we have download XAMPP. So just simply open that, and you can see the latest version of XAMPP at the time of making of this video is version 8.2.12. So whatever the latest version when you are installing this XAMPP, so probably when you'll be watching you can see a different version. But all I can say is whatever process that I'm showing on this video will be pretty much same. Alright, and this link also I'm going to put right in your description, so you can directly use that link also to land over to the official site of XAMPP. Right, so once you are here, this is our latest version. You have to click on this download button. So awesome, our download will be starting soon. So you can go back to our previous directory. So on our source fortnet, it's going to start shortly downloading of our XAMPP. So you can see it is rightly started downloading XAMPP, right? So let's cancel this, as I have already downloaded it. So I'll go to my download directory, and you can see already we have that XAMPP is downloaded over here. So just simply double click on the installer. It will ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes, and let's minimize our download directory. So welcome to XAMPP, and can see welcome to XAMPP setup wizard is rightly opened over here. So let's click on next. So these are all files that it's going to install, which is totally fine. You can keep this all default and click on next over here. So it's going to create a XAMPP folder on our C drive, which is again totally fine. Just simply click on next. So default language is English, so you can always change it to another language if you wish. Let's click on next over here. So it's ready to be installed. Click on next, and you can see it has rightly started installing our XAMPP, right? So it will take some time, about a couple of minutes. So once we are done with this, I'm going to again back to this video. So we'll come back, and now you can clearly see completing XAMPP setup wizard is rightly open. So our XAMPP is successfully installed. So do you want to start XAMPP control panel now? So yes, I want to start my XAMPP control panel, as I am going to show you how to run PHP on our local host. So for that, first click on finish. So that will launch our XAMPP control panel, and you can see XAMPP control panel is subsequently launched over here. So first thing that you need to do is you need to start our Apache. So you can see our Apache is rightly started now, and you need to also start our MySQL. So click on start, and you can see our MySQL is also started as well. Alright, so now it is properly done. You can always minimize our XAMPP control panel. It's time to create some code. So just simply click on this explorer and go to your C drive, and you need to go to the XAMPP control panel. So go inside the XAMPP control panel, and here you'll be seeing we have a htdocs folder, right? So you need to go inside that htdocs folder. So always remember whatever projects you are creating on PHP, so you need to put that PHP folder within htdocs folder, right? So you need to right click, and let's create a new folder called php-practice. So I'll just simply go inside that php practice folder. I'll just simply right click and create a new text document, and I'm going to give that text document name as hello, and I'm going to change that .txt with .php. All right, hit enter. And do you want to change the file name extension? Yes, I want to change the file name extension. So now it is properly changed with PHP file type. So if you are unable to see something like this, then what you need to do is you need to click on view, and then you need to click on the show, and you need to enable this file name extensions. So you can see just beside this we have a tick icon, right? So that means it is properly enabled file name extension. So once you have that enabled, you will be able to see this .php or .py or .java, so that sort of file name extensions properly coming. So once you have that, you can see hello.php. So let's right click on the file and open it in Notepad. So I'm opening the hello.php file on one Notepad, and here I'm going to write a simple PHP code snippet. So angular bracket PHP, then end that angular bracket with question, then angular bracket, and here what I'm going to do is I'm going to echo hello world, right? So after writing this much code snippet, you need to go to file and you need to save this file. So once you have successfully written this code and have saved this file, it's time to get that output called hello world on our browser, right? So that is the intent. So what you need to do is now you need to go to your browser and to just simply open a new tab, and here you need to just simply type localhost, that's all, and then you need to give a slash and to provide this folder name. So remember, we have created a PHP practice folder name, right? So you need to right click into go to this rename option and you need to copy this folder path, PHP practice folder path, and then you need to go to your browser again. So after localhost, you need to give a slash and then you need to right click and paste that folder path over here, PHP practice folder path, hit enter, and immediately you'll be seeing that it is properly showing this hello.php file under PHP practice, right? So now to run this hello.php file and to get that output, you need to just simply click on this file and there you go. You can see the output is properly coming, right? Whatever you have written over here, hello world, is properly showing up over here. So let's say you change this hello world with hello everyone, and you are again going to file and saving this file. So now it should be showing hello everyone, right, on our browser. So once you refresh this, you can see now it is showing hello everyone, right? So in this way, you can easily install XAMPP. You can use XAMPP as a server and you can run your PHP programs on our local host. So in this way, you can easily run your PHP files on our local host. And I have also started Geeky Syntax channel. So here regularly I'm posting coding related videos. So do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel as well. And I have also started Geeky Script vlogging channel. So this channel also you can subscribe. So that's basically all about this video. I have rightly showed you how you can easily run a PHP file on a local host. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.